So far, so good. We have done the modeling part for this bottle. And today, we are going to see how we can adding some simple materials and render this bottle. So let's get started by making an plane. This plane will be around 2 meters by 2 meters. And we will select these two vertices. If you have seen that this plane is large, you can scale it to this distance and move it in the x-axis like this. And you can select. So I will move to here, and I will extrude in the axis around 1 meter, maybe moving 1 meter and making some bevel here, control B, and adding some loop cuts and adding finally the shade smooth. So we will move in the y axis until we have reached this point. After that, we can adding some material for this one. We have the bottle will be black, and we will see how we can adding a simple logo for this bottle. But for this one, we can adding some simple white material will be diffuse, not emitting any light. Let's see what we have the diffuse here, and it will be completely white such as this. For the bottle, it will be an principal shading, so it will be black glossy. And after that, we will say that it will be color of black, and let's see what we have there. So the specular will be 0.5, roughness will be around 0.08, and the subsurf color, we will not using any subsurf, but the metallic, it will be maybe let's try 0.4. It will not be plastic, it will be shiny, and that's why we will using the black color. And after that, this will be an metal gold. And again, we will say the surface will be principled, and the color will be some gold such as this. And again, the metallic will be metallic, and roughness will be 0.15 maybe, and adding some clear coat, so clear coat will be 0.25, and clear coat. So the clear coat adds some layer we have this one, maybe right. Again, this will be an glass, so we will start to adding some glass material, and this will be such as this, and all as we expect. Let's see what we have there. This will be also an metal gold, and this will be also metal gold, except this one. Let's zoom in such as this, and this will be an plastic. So we'll add another material, which is a plastic white. And after that, we will say that it has the sharing the same to be white. And again, metallic will be 0, specular 0.5, and the roughness 0.1, color will be white, and assign this to be here. For the gold material, we will see that in the viewport it will be gold. So in the viewport display, color will be this one. And let's go here, and roughness will be 0, I think, maybe 0.01. So this determines the thickness for our glass. We have now added materials. Let's add our lighting. So we will try to adding a mesh here. This will be in this distance, and again, let's try to rotate in rotate to be here, and this will be our main light. Again, assign an emission shader, and let's try to use it to be 11. Color will be slightly yellow, and let's try using another plane, and this plane will be in this direction, and another time it will be fill light, and this will be maybe yellow, I mean blue, and you should use the emission shader, and again it will be fill of one and such as this. And I'd like to add some simple area light here, or adding some another plane. This will be our top light, and this top light will be an emission one, and maybe such as this. Don't forget to add a camera. Your scene will not render unless you add a camera. So it, we have cycles, we have GB compute. Let's save. We have render of 2000, and we have the performance of, let's say, this large tile size. We want to only render one cube or one square. And again, let's try to test our scene. So far, so good. We have this image. So as you can see, this isn't suitable way for rendering an image, because we have our main image here, or our main bottle here, but all 9% of the image is empty. So we will fix it in the next part, and in the next part we'll see how we can adding an HDRI to add some reflection, which is fine, and we will see how we can adding some another bottles, how we can add depth of field, how we can refix our dimensions to be better. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. See you in the next tutorial.